Hello, and welcome to the BMC Quick Course Series. My name is Dave Levy, and I'm a lead product developer based in the Atlanta, Georgia area. In this session, I'll show you some of the new features introduced in version 2.3 of Total Object Manager, or TOM. The new version of TOM is focused on usability and modernization, so let's get started. TOM 2.3 now has deployable definition bases. With this, you can now manage all your dev bases from a central location. When ready to use the dev base, it can be deployed to local TOMs and or to remote TOMs in another TOMplex within the same CASplex. This feature can simplify change management by allowing changes to be made and approved in a copy of the current dev base. Once approved, the copy can be deployed over the top of the currently active dev base to implement the changes without disrupting anything. Another usability improvement is to allow you to turn off unwanted confirmation dialogs to save time when managing objects. For junior members of the administration team, prompts to avoid unexpected changes are very useful. For expert members, this extra step can be a burden. The use of most common dialogs can now be controlled as needed. In TOM 2.3, we have enhanced the concept of model inheritance to make it easier to use. Models have always been able to provide default values for objects, but in the past it was difficult to know what properties were inherited and which were not when inspecting object properties. The UI has been improved so you can easily identify inherited values when editing an object. Several views have been enhanced with new line commands to let you see all the object properties, including inherited ones. Lastly, most views are now context-sensitive to allow you to manage objects in other TOMplexes within the CASplex from a single UI session. This avoids the need to run UI sessions on multiple systems to have access to multiple TOMplexes. The user interface for TOM 2.3 has been completely overhauled to modernize its look and feel. TOM now takes advantage of MainView Explorer features such as checkboxes and radio buttons. The new UI now has a more consistent look and feel when compared to other products in the MainView family. Here is a sample of a modernized dialog. Notice the use of checkboxes identified with the red arrows. Checkboxes allow you to choose one or more independent options from a list. The use of checkboxes more clearly identifies the default value for an option if it is not checked. For example, the first arrow points to restart only. Since the only checkbox is to select yes, it is clear that the default when not checked is no, without the need to have the no option actually visible. This is an example of a set of radio buttons. For radio buttons, only one of the list of options can be selected. Selecting a different option in the list turns on the selected option and turns off any other selected option. This makes it clear that you can choose one and only one of the related values. Another feature of the modernized UI is the ability for it to show you what values have been inherited from a model. As mentioned earlier, models can be used to set up default values for objects. In this example, you will notice that some values have an asterisk next to them. The asterisk indicates that the value or option was inherited from the model. You can, of course, override the inherited value if desired. Another example of the improved UI usability is that most views are now hybrid views. There is a static section at the top that allows for applying filters or making other specifications without the need to invoke a separate dialog. This saves time and increases the value of the view itself, since you can see where the data is coming from. In this example of a hybrid view style, you can easily verify that the objects being displayed are from the default dev base. If objects from a different dev base are wanted, the edit dev base name can be overtyped to temporarily change the edit dev base for this view. Thank you for your time. For more information on any BMC mainframe product, please visit the URL shown here.